Okay, for the first one, we have a quartic expression in the expanded form. And ideally speaking, we would like to factor this as a product of two quadratics. But the main question is, how do we do that, right? Well, let's look at an easier case first. Namely, how do we factor a quadratic, let's say x squared plus 5x plus 6? Well, one way to do this is the cross method, and that's just you break down x squared, which is x times x, and then we look at 6. What times 12 give us 6? Let's use 2 and 3. Why not 6 times 1, right? Well, we take this times that, which is 3x, and we take this times that, which gives us 2x. Together, we do get the 5x. So we know we have the correct combination. The factor is x plus 2 here, and then we have another one, x plus 3. So this right here is the cross method. And now the question is, can we do the similar thing for this right here? And the answer is yes. And in fact, I thought about this on my own, so I was pretty proud of it. So let's see how we can actually make this work. First, let's look at x to the fourth power. The only way is x squared times x squared. That's for sure. Thankfully, this is the 1, right? But if it's not 1, yeah, it's just going to be more bizarre, that's all. Now, I would like to go to the middle term right here. Remember, this is going to be a factor in the quadratic form, likewise this right here. So this part is going to be with x. Now we will just have to ask ourselves, what should we put right here and right here? Do we look at the 12 and ask ourselves, what times 12 give us 12? Like 2 times 6, 3 times 4 will mean maybe negatives? In fact, no. We cannot just look at this term and that term and then use 12. No. Right now, I'm just going to put down a and b. And it's not true that to say a times b has to be equal to 12. This right here is not true. Because this is not the only way to produce this term. We will also have to consider the x squared term right here times the constant term for the second factor. And likewise, this constant term times this x squared. So these numbers are going to matter too. So right now, we'll just put down ax and also bx. What good does this do? Well, this is the part that we can do the cross method. So this is like the first cross method. And we do another one. This is the double cross method. So right here, I'm just going to take this, multiply by that, and we'll get bx to the third power. And then we take this times that, we get ax to the third power. And in fact, these are the only two ways to produce the x to the third power terms. So we must have this plus that being equal to negative 4x to the third power. So just look at the coefficient. We must have a plus b being equal to negative 4. Now, let's look at the constant term, which is 15. And for this right here, we'll just have to kind of guess and check, like what we did right here, and hope for the best. 15, I know it's like 1 times 15. No, don't do that. Let's try 3 times 5. So let me put down 3 here and also 5 here. What do we do next though? Well, we do this. Take this times that, which is 5ax. Take this times that, which is 3bx. And in fact, these are the only two ways to produce the x term. So we must have this coefficient plus that coefficient equals that. So we can write this down as 5a plus 3b equals negative 16. And now as we can see, we have a system of equations. And let's solve it real quick. Let's multiply everybody by negative 3 here. And that will give us 12 here. And then we'll just add them so they cancel. So this and that is 2a equals this and that is going to be negative 4. So that means a is equal to negative 2. And when a is equal to negative 2, plugging here, we know b is also just happened to be negative 2. All right, this is wonderful, huh? But does this really work? There's one number that we haven't used yet, and that's the 12 right here. So this is how we do it. We can put back the negative 2 here and also the negative 2 here. All right, and what we do first is we multiply this 2. And you can just write down the coefficient, but just to be clear, I will also write down the x term. So this times that is going to be positive 4x squared. And then we'll take this, multiply with this, which is the 5x squared. And then one more from here to here. we multiply, we get 3x squared. And together, when we add them up, we know we have 12x squared. We got it. Yes. I know it works out so wonderfully, right? Yeah, because I make this. Yeah. But anyway, though, the factor for this is just reading across. So this is equal to x squared minus 2x and then plus 3 times the other factor, x squared minus 2x plus 5. And ladies and gentlemen, here we have it. This is the factor for the first one. Now for the second one, we notice that this is just from the first question. And then at the end here, we minus the 3. Yeah, I made all these questions. Yeah. So one way to do this is just multiply everybody and then minus 3 and do the double cross method again. But we don't have to, because we have this in this particular form for a reason. Notice this right here is x squared minus 2x, likewise this. But for the first one, we have plus 5, and the second one, we have plus 3. They are just off by 2. And to make everything much easier for us to follow, we can just do a substitution. So the second method here is the substitution when the expression is nicely set up. I'm going to let u to be my new variable. I will just call that to be the first parentheses here. So x squared minus 2x plus 5. So this expression becomes u times, well, this right here is u but minus 2. Because this is 3, right? Just minus 2 here, minus 2 here. And then don't forget we still have that minus 3 here. Now, this is going to be so much easier for us to handle. Distribute and all that, so we get u squared minus 2u and then minus 3. How do we do this? Yeah, the little cross method I showed you earlier. But we can do this in our head. This right here is just going to be u minus 3 times u plus 1. What's u? U is that, right? So on all, we have what? X squared minus 2x, 5 minus 3, we have plus 2. And then this one, x squared minus 2x, 5 plus 1, so we have plus 6. And you know what? We are done. Yeah, so thanks to this particular form, we can do a substitution. Okay, this looks like a special case, huh? Because we have x cubed, and then this is a perfect square, and then just plus a number. This is still a quadratic expression. If you really want to, we can just multiply this out and then combine the terms and then do the double cross again. But I'm going to leave that to you guys. It works though. Let's see. How can we take advantage of this kind of form? Again, we have x cubed and then something square and a number. This number is not really doing us any good. One way that we like to use when we are factoring polynomials is factor by grouping, and sometimes maybe we'll have to add a number or subtract number and things like that, right? So this 7 is kind of suspicious. This is how we can actually make it better for us. Here we have a cube. Ideally speaking, if we can somehow also have a cube number, then we can either do the sum of two cubes or the difference of two cubes. Here we have a perfect square. So if we have another square number, maybe you can do the difference of two squares. So let's take a look at perfect cubes. And then I'm also going to put down the perfect squares. Is it possible for us to find a combination of this and that and we get 7? It's plus or minus maybe. Yes. Look at this. 8 minus 1 gives us 7. So let's go ahead and write the 7 as 8 minus 1. And I'm going to put the 8 next to the x cubed. So let's see what will happen. Okay, so here we have x cubed, and then we are going to add 8 to it. And then I'm just going to keep this right here, x squared minus 2x plus 5 squared, but we also need to have the minus 1. Now this is so much better, because you'll see, this right here, we can just factor it as the sum of two cubes. So we will get x plus 2 times x squared minus 2x and then plus 4. Done. Then we are going to add for the second term, this part, yeah, We can just factor this as the difference of two squares. So we take this minus 1, so we will just have x squared minus 2x plus 5 minus 1, which is plus 4. And again, this right here is just because 5 minus 1. And the other factor from here is x squared minus 2x plus 5 plus 1. So that would be plus 6. So again, this is 5 plus 1. What do we see? Yes. Notice this works out so nicely, this and that. And I know a lot of these factoring equations, they are all like purposely set up so that it works out like that. But hopefully I showed you guys the thought process, and that's how you approach solving like difficult questions, right? So how to make things happen. That's how I like to say it. All right, so we're going to put that out. So ladies and gentlemen, we will have the first factor, and that will be the x squared minus 2x plus 4. And then the second factor is this combining with that. So let's put down x to the second power first. And then here we have the minus 2x plus x. So that will be minus x. And lastly, plus 6 plus 2. That will be plus 8. Yes. So again, we factored it. And I should have told you guys that none of the quadratic factors that you guys see in these videos is factorable, so that's why I didn't bother with any of that.